Good morning children, I hope class 6 children are watching this video and I hope you must be keeping well. As in previous videos we had seen integers and we have completed exercises. I hope you must have completed. Those who have not completed, again it will be my earnest request that you complete all the chapters of integers and proper practice is required. And today we are going to start a new chapter, that is fractions. And under these fractions we are going to see in this class fractions and fractional numbers. Some examples we will see and we will try to complete exercise 5A. So together be with your book, copy and pencil so that together while watching, just after watching you can complete this exercise. Let's start. Here you see we have fractions and fractional numbers. Look at the given figure. In this figure, a strip had been divided into 7 equal parts. Out of these 7 equal parts, 4 parts have been shaded. Clearly, the shaded portion represents 4 sevenths. Here you see, if suppose this strip has been given and that has been divided into 7 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And these portions have been shaded. So this shaded portion, if you want to represent or you want to write in number, what we will write? First we will count the parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parts we have. And out of 7, how many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will write 4 by 7. And this is called, this represents 4 sevenths. We say 4 sevenths or 4 by 7. In numeral we denote it by 4 by 7 and write as 4 by 7. Here 4 by 7 is a fraction and 4 sevenths, what we are saying, is a fractional number. So that you need to remember. 4 by 7 if you are writing, this is a fraction, and 4 sevenths what we say, that is called fractional number. Another example you see, suppose you have one whole chapati. This has been divided into 4 equal parts. So if it will be said 1 quarter, 1 quarter means what? Quarter means 4. So 1 quarter means 1 by 4. 1 quarter means 1 by 4. So when you write 1 quarter, when you write 1 quarter, it means 1 by 4. So this 1 quarter, when you are saying, or 1 fourth, when you are saying, this is called fractional number. Either when you are saying 1 quarter or 1 fourth, this is called fractional number. And in numeral what we read this 1 by 4. Fractions on number line. Here you see, suppose we want to denote the fraction 4 by 7 on the number line. How it to be done and how it is represented. What is required to be done? As we have seen integers, how it is represented on number line. In the same way, what is needed to be done? One number line is required to be drawn. And suppose here you have 0 and here one unit you have taken 1, or any name also can be given for this. Now if you want to represent 4 by 7, what is needed to be done? We need to see denominator. In denominator we have 7. So this whole part, one part, is required to be divided into 6 equal parts. So suppose you divide this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 7th equal part we will divide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 equal part we have divided. And if you want to show 4 by 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, this will be your 4 by 7. So here this first one will be called 1 by 7, 2 by 7. 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7, and this will be 7 by 7. 7 by 7 means what? If you are dividing this, you are getting 1. 7 by 7. So what is needed to be done? If any fractional number you have and that is required to be shown on number line, we need to see denominator first. And in denominator, suppose 7 is there, so this whole unit or whole portion is required to be divided into 7 equal portion, and then you see numerator, and from 0 you count that. Suppose here you have 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4. This point will be your 4 by 7. In the same way, suppose another example you see, suppose 5 by 8 you have. What is needed to be done? Again, one number 9 is required to be drawn. Here you have suppose 0, here you have 1. Now, you see denominator 8 you have. So this portion is required to be divided into 8 equal portions. So here you have suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Here you see how many portions are divided, has been divided. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you need to show 5 by 8. From here you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this will be your 5 by 8. So I hope you understood how fractional number is shown in number 9. Here you see, some more examples are given below. Suppose fraction 1 by 2, this in fractional number what we will say is 1 half. 1 half, how this is represented if in straight you want to show, so this, in figure if you want to show, in this way this can be represented. This portion, shaded portion is 1 by 2. And in number line if you want to show, here you have denominator 2. So this portion has been divided into 2 equal portions and this first one is 1 by 2. 1 quarter means what? 1 quarter means 1 fourth. It means 1 by 4. In number 9, what is needed to be done? This is required to be divided into 4 equal parts and first part will be 1 by 4. In the same way, this has been written. Suppose 5 eighths. 5 eighths means 5 by 8. This straight has been divided into 8 equal part and 5 portion has been shaded. If you want to show in number 9, this whole portion has been divided into 8 equal part and 5th one will be your 5 by 8. Thus the fractions shown above are 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 2 by 3, 3 by 5 and 5 by 8. Fraction is a part of a collection. Fraction is what? That is a part of whole collection. Here you see in figure 1, contains a collection of 8 circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And out of that, 3 circles are shaded. So this can be seen as 3 by 8. Here shaded portion you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And whole collection is what? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. By whole collection is how much? 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 8 by 15. So in this way, we can represent and in number if you want to write, this can be written. Then you have fractions. The numbers of the form A by B, where A and B are natural numbers, are called fractions. So here you see fractions are what? The numbers of the form A by B. The number is written in the form of A by B. But A and B should be natural numbers, no integers. Don't get confused. Sometimes we write 1 by 2 suppose. So this is not a fraction. This is what? This is a rational number. This is a rational number that you have not studied now. So, in fraction we have natural number, but in rational number also is represented by A by B, but here A by B should be integer. And B must not be equal to 0. But here you have A and B should be natural number. So, automatically that if it is natural number, B will not be 0. So, in fraction, we consider the number which is represented by a by b, and where a and b should be natural numbers, means counting number. Here a is called the numerator and b is the denominator of the fraction a by b. Suppose here example has been given 5 by 9 and 8 by 17, where numerator is 5, denominator is 9, and here numerator you have 8 and denominator 17. Fractional part of a collection, here you see, find 3 by 4 of 12. So consider the collection of 12 balls. Here you have 12 balls. Divide this collection into 4 equal parts and take 3 parts out of it. Here you see, try to understand. Here you have 12. So what is required to be done? 12 balls, collection of 12 balls has been taken. Divide this collection into 4 equal parts. This is in denominator, in division. So in 4 equal parts that has been divided. 1, 2, 3, 4. And take 3 parts out of it. If 3 parts you are taking out of it, disposal, suppose any three parts you have taken. Three parts you have taken means these three parts you have taken. 1, 2, 3. In 4 equal parts has been divided and 3 parts you have taken. How many balls are there? 9 balls are there. So in shortcut method, if you want to solve this, how it will be solved, here you see. 3 by 4, 4 of 12. So this will be 3 by 4 of can be written as multiplication into 12 means 12 by 1. Now here you see 4 1 is 4, 4 3 is 12. And here 3 3 is 9 by 1 means 9. Here you see 5 by 8 of 32. 5 by 8 of 32. It means what? 5 by 8 into 32. 8 1 is 8, 8 4 is 32, 5 4 is 20. And this will be your answer. Example 3, you see, what fraction of a day is 8 hours? So you need to know in one day how many hours are there? 24 hours. So the required fraction will be 8 by 24. What fraction of a day is 8 hours? So 8 by 24. What fraction of an hour is 40 minutes? Means 40 by 60. Hour means 60 minutes. So 40 by 60. In the given figure, if we say that the shaded region is 1 by 2 of the whole, then what is the error in it? In the given figure, the shaded region is not equal to the unshaded region. Therefore, shaded region is not equal to 1 by 2 of the whole. Here you see, if this figure has been given, and shaded region, just you see, by seeing itself, this is not equal. If it will be said this is half, this cannot be true. If half you want to say, in this way this should be. This portion can be said half. So this can be said half, and so unshaded portion will be half. So this is not equal. Then we have exercise 5A. Here you see, write the fraction representing the shaded portion. So immediately, you try to solve by yourself. Write the fraction representing the shaded portion. Here you see, for this what you need to do. First of all, you need to count all the portions, and that you need to write in denominator. How many portions are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Shaded portion, 1, 2, 3. That is required to be written in numerator. Here you see, how would you write? Shaded portion we need to write down. So first of all, total portion we will write, that is 4. Shaded portion is 1. Here you see, total portion 1, 2, 3. Shaded portion 2. This will be your answer. I hope you will understand and you will be able to solve. This you try to solve by yourself. Here she said 4 by 9 of the given figure. Here you see how many portions are there in denominator 9 is there. 9 it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 4 portion is required to be shaded. So any 4 you take, suppose these 4 you can take and this will be called 4 by 9. In the given figure, if we say that the shaded region is 1 by 4, then identify the error in it. 1 by 4 if it would be safe, all the portions should be equal, rest all, because one whole portion has been divided into 4 equal parts. If 4 equal part is there, 4 equal part, then only one portion can be said 1 by 4. But it is not equal. These all portions are not equal and that's why this is not 1 by 4. Write a fraction for each of the following. 3/4. 3/4 means what? 3 by 4. 4/7 means 4 by 7. 2/5 means 2 by 5. So in the same way, you need to write these all. 3/10, 3 by 10. 1/8, 1 by 8. 5/6, 5 by 6. 8/9, 8 by 9. 7/12 means 7 by 12. Next question you see, write down the numerator and the denominator of each of the fractions given below. So here you see, this will be called denominator. This will be called numerator. So in the same way, you need to write for each. Write down the fraction in which numerator is 3, denominator is 8. So fraction will be here. First, your fraction will be 3 by 8. Here, 5 by 12. So easy it is. I hope you will be able to do. Rest of the question you solve. Question number 7 you see. Write down the fractional number for each of the following. Fractional number you need to write down. So here we will write 2/3. Here we'll write 4/9. So in the same way you need to write. Here you see, as it has been written here, 3/4, 4/7, 3/10, 5/6. In this way, you need to write these fractions. Next you see, what fraction of an hour is 24 minutes? As in example it was given, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Therefore, this will be 24 by 60. How many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10? What fraction of them are prime numbers? Just you see. 2 to 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, here it has been written how many natural numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You have only one is not there. So, 9 natural numbers we have. What fraction of them are prime numbers? Prime numbers are the numbers which is having only two factors, 1 and itself. So, your prime numbers are 2, 3, 5 and 7. That's it. So, 4 prime numbers you have. 2, 3, 5 and 7. Then you have determine 2 by 3 of 15 pence. 2 by 3 of 15 pence means 2 by 3 into 15. And this you can cancel. 3, 1, 3, 3, 3, 5, 10. 15. Now you multiply 2, 5, 10 pence. And this will be your answer. So in this way, these questions are required to be solved. Here you have 3 by 4 of 16 cups. Means 3 by 4 into 16. Here you can cancel 4, 1, 4 and 4, 4, 16 means 12 cups. So in this way you need to do this. Next question you have. Neelam has 25 pencils. She gives 4/5 of them to Meena. How many pencils does Meena get? Here you see, will you solve? Neelam has 25 pencils, she gives 4/5 of them to Meena. Here you write. Neelam has 25 pencils. She gave to, here you write, has. She gave to Meena how much? 4/5 of them, means 4/5 of 25. It means 4/5 into 25. 5 5 25 means 20 pencils she gave to Meena. How many pencils does Meena get? So therefore Meena got 20 pencils. How many pencils are left with Neelam? Therefore Neelam is left with 25 minus 20, it means 5 pencils. Neelam had 25 pencils. Out of 25, she gave 4/5 of them to Meena. So Meena got 4/5 of 25, it means 20 pencils. So Meena already has got 20 pencils. So now Neelam remained with 25 minus 20, it means 5 pencils. Next we have represent each of the following fractions on the number line. Here you see, one question I will solve, rest of the questions you try to solve by yourself. What is required to be done for this? Number line is required to be drawn in this way. One, here you see, start with 0 and here suppose you have 1 and name can be given, suppose A and B. Now you can see 3/8 if you want to show. You want to represent on number 9. What is required to be done? 8, you see, denominator. So this portion is required to be divided into 8 equal portion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And for dividing this, what is required to be done? What is needed to be done? Just you draw a line with the help of ruler, fix a point, and then you take compass. And with the help of compass, one unit distance you take like this, and then you divide. So equally it will be divided. In this way it is required to be divided. Now here you see, 3/8 you need to show. 1, 2, 3. So this will be your 3/8. In the same way, these questions are required to be done. I hope you will be able to do. And in this way, we have completed this exercise. Exercise 5A. Rest remaining few questions are there, you must solve. And next day we will see proper, improper and mixed fractions. Until then, thank you.